rarely what they seem. Yes, a magician has the ability to influence the audience into a false sense of free will while really holding on the puppet strings. A magician may walk up to you and say, pick up a card, choose a card, your free will, any card you want. Though outwardly it may seem like he's offering you a choice to pick up any card you want, but in most of the cases, your mind has already fallen right into the magician's trap. Yes, pulling off a magic trick does not require spells or magic words. Rather, the magician's key supporter, I should say, yeah, the magician's key supporter is the ability to persuade an audience to make a particular decision while making them believe that they are choosing it freely. Yes, the audience has absolutely no idea that they are influenced and they feel that they have absolute choices, absolute control over their choices. Sometimes they even make up imaginary reasons to justify their choices, not knowing that those choices are actually forced by the magician. I started performing magic shows when I was 7 years old, and since then, my journey of exploring various ways of tweaking people's perceptions began. The art of magic had a lot to teach me other than just magic tricks. Yes, a lot of what people talk about, body language, attention, memory, perception, human psychology, behaviors, I had been practicing all of it, but as a magician. In my teens, I got more interested in mind matters and wanted to, you know, add on to my knowledge in the field of psychology. And then it dawned on me that what we magicians were doing in the field of magic, in real life, the same thing happens. A lot of the decisions that we make are highly influenced by external factors that we are not even aware of. Yeah. It's like the implications extend far beyond the magician's stage. Despite a song's strong sense of freedom, our ability to deliberately make choices can often be a big illusion. Having a free will to make a choice can just be a feeling, not even connected to the decision at all. Most people assume that they are free agents, that their fate lies in their own hands, but they'd be wrong. Because sometimes we are as helpless as those string puppets being shaken by someone else's subtle influence. Without even feeling the pull, we go for their bidding while thinking that it is all our idea. It's like you go to a restaurant and you order a meal. You are twice likely to order something from the very top or very bottom of the menu because those areas strike your eye first. Similarly, in media houses, a lot of the ads are charged higher depending on the position of the ads in the newspapers. Millions are spent on consultants who provide advice on the placements of products in supermarkets and malls. You know, those television ads are constantly manipulating our choices and our spending habits. It's like, there is evidence that says that if someone offers us a hot drink, we choose to believe the person to be warmer. Or a person with a nasty odor, you know, we feel morally disgusted sitting with that person, and it causes us to judge the person more harshly. Our choices are constantly being tampered with. Most of our favorite, our dream vacation spots, our career choices, our college courses, even our perception of happiness is highly influenced. We find it difficult in accepting that we are so often being persuaded because we want to believe that we have absolute control over our decisions. We tend to believe that our choices are the external reflections of our inner values. Our choices when we vote, to whom we marry, when we go shopping, what we wear, our dietary decisions, even how we live. We believe that our choices define us, they express us. Our instincts make us believe that we are great at decision making, that our preferences matter, and our choices have meaningful outcomes. Now, despite what our instincts have us to believe, it's very important to understand that there is a lot of subconscious conditioning by the external factors that are playing a major role in our choices. Let me show it to you how. And to do this, I again need a volunteer from the audience. So anyone? Oh, please. Yeah, please, please, please. Asha, right?
Deepika.
No, Deepika, sorry. So I have Deepika on stage. So Deepika, can we just step a little behind here?
Yeah.
Now, as I say, our choices are usually influenced. I have two newspapers. I want you to choose one. You sure? Or you want to change your mind?
I'm sure.
You sure?
Yeah.
You're definitely sure and you don't want to change your mind?
Yeah.
You want me to go with your choice?
Yeah.
Okay. So Deepika has chosen...
I don't like the newspaper, but it's okay.
That's fine. So Deepika has chosen a newspaper for me. All I'm going to do is I'm going to cut down a column from this. I'll not take a lot of time and cut the one that comes here. So I've just got a column over here that from a newspaper chosen by you.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
I'm again going to give you some options to choose from. And I want you to have your free will and choose as freely as you can. Correct? A column from the newspaper you selected. I'm going to roll my scissor over here. Mm-hmm. And wherever you ask me to stop, I'm going to stop and cut the paper from there.
Okay.
It's your free choice. To ask me to stop wherever you want.
Stop.
A little higher?
No, here.
A little lower?
No, here.
Are you 100% sure?
200% sure.
As you wish.
Okay.
I'm not going to touch that paper.
Okay.
Because some people are quite skeptic when magicians do things. I want you to pick up that paper if you can, please.
Yeah, sure.
And I want you to show to the audience from where did you ask me to cut. Could you read out the words? From where did you ask me to cut?
Another high in her career as she became the second in.
Can you see the first four words again and louder?
Another high in her career.
Louder. That's right, what you're reading.
What?
As I said, it was your free choice to choose this newspaper that you chose. It was your choice to ask me to stop wherever you wanted me to stop, never realizing that you were already influenced from the time the talk started. Thank you so much.
Oh my God, thank you.
So, the one gift that we have today, the one power that we have right now that can change our life, and that is the power of choice. We make choices every single day. And these small and big choices define the quality of your life. So I always say, choose growth, choose wisdom, choose happiness, choose courage. Next time, whatever you choose, whatever choice you make, ask yourself, was it really yours? Thank you.